Blu-ray discs are now part of everyday home video, and even though online streaming now plays a huge role in the market, the Blu-ray disc has a complete monopoly over optical content. A few years ago, however, this was not the case, and it looked like Sony would lose another format war to another product. But unlike with the Betamax in the 1980s, this was a battle that Sony was not going to lose. This is a story of HD DVD versus Blu-ray. At the turn of the millennium, high-definition televisions were becoming cheaper and cheaper. And much like today with 4K television, everyone wanted one. However, there was a distinct lack of content to use with these high-definition televisions. In the early 2000s, two companies pushed the development of high-definition discs to deliver high-definition content to consumers who had bought these televisions. One company was the Blu-ray Disc Association, which included Hitachi, LG, Panasonic, Pioneer, and of course, most importantly, Sony, among others. There was also another company, the DVD Forum, which was run by Toshiba, NEC, Sanyo, Intel, Microsoft, and RCA. They both worked hard and both produced two different disc formats. In 2002, the Blu-ray Disc Association launched the Blu-ray, and the Advanced Optical Disc was launched by the DVD Forum, renamed to HD DVD in 2003. Before both formats were pushed to consumer, there were attempts to avoid a format war. After all, no one wants to be on the losing side of a battle. However, the Blu-ray Disc Association's members, who made up the majority of disc player manufacturers, remembered the royalties they had to pay each time they sold a DVD player, and didn't want to risk losing billions to yet more royalties with a combined format. So, they both launched separately. HD DVD players and content were released in the United States on April 18th, 2006, and for a short period, they were the only high-definition content format around. Blu-ray launched later that year, in June, but by then HD DVD sales were mounting and both Blu-ray and Blu-ray players were more expensive than the competing format. Both formats had exclusive support of three of the major six film corporations. HD DVD had Universal Studios, Paramount and Warner Brothers, while Blu-ray disc had Columbia Pictures, Walt Disney Pictures and 20th Century Fox. By mid-2007, both formats were looking very strong. But the thing that killed Sony in the 80s would be the thing that would save them now, the rental market. In June 2007, Blockbuster Video, at the time the largest movie rental service, announced that more than 70% of high-definition rentals were in Blu-ray. And after this discovery, they moved to exclusive Blu-ray content in their stores and dropped all HD DVD content. A month later, Target also moved to an exclusive Blu-ray deal. And this was the first of many problems that would occur for HD DVD. In January 2008, Warner Brothers Studios, who had the largest market share of DVDs, announced plans to drop HD DVD completely by June 2008. This was then followed by Walmart's decision to phase out HD DVD completely by June the same year. The final nail in the coffin was the PlayStation 3. Launched in November 2006, the PlayStation incorporated a Blu-ray disc player as a standard feature, and its strong launch propelled the Blu-ray format forward. The Wii system did not play either format, and the already out Xbox 360 could play HD DVDs, but with an external add-on. By early February 2008, Sony announced that it had sold 10 million PlayStation 3 systems. It was estimated at the time that only 1 million HD DVD players had sold. And so, on February 19th, 2008, Toshiba, the biggest backer of the DVD Forum and HD DVD, announced that it would cease developing, manufacturing and marketing HD DVD players and recorders. This was effectively the end of HD DVD. Microsoft stopped producing their HD DVD add-on for the Xbox 360, and the last HD DVD was released on March 18th, 2008. HD DVD was dead. So, what did you think of HD DVD? Did you pluck up a cheap player and then found no disc to play? Or did you jump on Blu-ray at the time and found success there? Leave me a comment below, as well as any ideas for future videos. And I'll see everyone next time. Hopefully, that was a bit of technology.